We often watch and hear news of accidents where a truck hits, injures, damages a property, and even claims lives. But after such headlines, we know not of what happened to such incident. In this case, we will try to explain what are the happenings and the liabilities of the driver and the truck owners. Disclaimer: our videos on laws are based on actual cases. The facts stated have been made public via publications and the internet. Should any detail, especially of the petitioner, respondent, and appellant, appeal offensive in any way, kindly leave a comment or message us in our Facebook and we'll be more than happy to change the details accordingly. In the case of Rafael Reyes Trucking Corp versus People, we will give the different liabilities pertaining to the driver, vehicle owner, and what the victims or heirs are entitled to the obligation and liabilities of the accused, even if it is not intentional or the accident was due to negligence. Facts: on October 10, 1989, Romeo Dunca Ditamol was charged with reckless imprudence resulting in double homicide and damage to property. Accused driving a trailer truck tractor registered to Rafael Reyes Trucking Corporation hit and bump a Nissan pickup truck driven by Feliciano Balsita. Serious physical injuries and died. Francisco D. Jr. Upon arraimment on October 23, 1989, the accused entered a plea of not guilty. The offended parties, Rosario P., D., and minor children, and Angelina M., Balsita, and minor son, Paolo, made a reservation to file a separate civil action. On November 29, 1989, the offended parties also filed a complaint against petitioner Rafael Reyes Trucking Corporation. As employer of driver Romeo Dunca Ditamol, based on quasi delic, the petitioner settled the claim of their hires of Feliciano Balsita, the driver of the other vehicle involved in the accident. The private respondents opted to pursue the criminal action but did not withdraw the civil case quasi ex delicto they filed against petitioner. On December 15, 1989, the offended parties withdrew the separate civil action against the accused and opted to prosecute the civil aspect ex delicto in the criminal action. However, they did not withdraw the separate civil action based on quasi delict against petitioner as employer arising from the same act or omission of the accused driver. Upon agreement of the parties, the trial court consolidated both criminal and civil cases and conducted trial of the same. Plaintiffs procurement of a writ of attachment of the properties of the corporation was declared illegal by Court of Appeals. On June 6, 1992, the trial court rendered a decision. Number 1. Finding the accused Romeo Dunca Ditamol guilty beyond reasonable doubt of the crime of double homicide, reckless imprudence with violation of the motor vehicle law. Rep. Act Number 4136. Number 2. Ordering the plaintiff to pay the defendant therein damages in the amount of 84,000 pesos and ordering the dismissal of the complaint in civil case. On September 3, 1992, petitioner Reyes Trucking and the accused filed a notice of appeal. On the other hand, private respondents moved from amendment of the dispositive portion of the decision so as to hold petitioner subsidiarily liable for the damages awarded to the private respondents in the event insolvency of the accused. On October 26, 1992, the trial court rendered a supplemental decision amending the dispositive portion by inserting an additional paragraph reading as follows: ordering the defendant Reyes Trucking Corporation subsidiarily liable for all the damages awarded to the heirs of Francisco D. Jr. in the event of insolvency of the accused, but deducting therefrom the damages of 84,000 pesos awarded to said defendant in the next preceding paragraph. Issue 1. Reyes Trucking Corporation will be subsidiarily liable for the damages awarded to the offended parties. Held. No. Petition granted. We grant the petition resolving under the circumstances pro hac vice remand the cases to the trial court for determination of the civil liability of petitioner as employer of the accused driver in the civil action quasi ex delicto open for the purpose. In negligence cases, the aggrieved party has a choice between 1. An action to enforce civil liability arising from crime under Article 100 of the Revised Penal Code, and 2. A separate action for quasi under Article 2176 of the Civil Code of the Philippines. Once the choice is made, the injured party cannot avail himself of any remedy because he may not recover damages twice for the same negligence act or omission of the accused. This rule is against double recovery. In the incident case, the offended parties elected to file a separate civil action for the damages against petitioner as employer of the accused, based on quasi delict under Article 2176 of the Civil Code of the Philippines. Private respondent sued petitioner Rafael Reyes Trucking Corp as the employer of the accused to be vicariously liable for the fault or negligence of the latter. Under the law, this vicarious liability of the employer is founded on at least 2 specific provisions of law. The first is expressed in Article 2176 in relation to Article 2180 of the Civil Code, which would allow an action predicated on quasi-delict to be instituted by the injured party against the employer for an act or a commission of the employee and would necessitate only a preponderance of evidence to prevail. Here, the liability of the employer for the negligent conduct of the subordinate is direct and primary, subject to the defense of due diligence in the selection and supervision of the employee. The enforcement of the judgment against the employer in an action based on Article 2176 does not require the employee to be insolvent since the nature of the liability of the employer with that of the employee, due being statutorily considered in tortfeasor, is solidary. The second, predicated on Article 103 of the Revised Penal Code, provides that an employer may be held subsidiarily civilly liable for a felony committed by his employee in the discharge of his duty. The liability attaches when the employee is convicted of a crime done in the performance of his work and is found to be insolvent that renders him unable to properly respond to the civil liability adjudged. Rafael Reyes Trucking Corp as employer of the accused has been adjudged guilty in the criminal case for reckless imprudence, cannot be held subsidiarily liable because of the filing of the separate civil action based on quasi-delict against it. In view of the reservation to the file and the subsequent filing of the civil action for recovery of civil liability, the same was not instituted with the criminal action. Such a separate civil action was for recovery of damages under Article 2176 of the Civil Code, arising from the same act or omission of the accused. Consequently, the Court of Appeals and the trial court erred in holding the accused civilly liable and the petitioner, employer of the accused, subsidiarily liable for damages arising from crime ex delicto in the crime action, as the offended parties in fact filed a separate civil action against the employer based on quasi delict, resulting in the waiver of the civil action ex delicto. Invoking this principle, we rule that the trial court erred in awarding civil damages in the criminal case and in dismissing the civil action. Apparently satisfied with such award, the private respondent did not appeal from the dismissal of the civil case. However, petitioner did appeal. Hence, this case should be remanded to the trial court so that it may render decision in the civil case awarding damages as may be warranted by the evidence. As a final note, we reiterate that the policy against double recovery requires that only one action be maintained for the same act or omission, whether the action is brought against the employee or against his employer. The injured party must choose which of the available causes of action for the damages he will bring. Under Article 365 of the Revised Penal Code, criminal negligence is treated as more of quasi-offense and dealt with separately from willful offenses. It is not a question of classification or terminology. In intentional crimes, the act itself is punished, and negligence or imprudence. What is principally penalized is the mental attitude or condition behind the act. Dangerous recklessness, lack of care or foresight, the imprudencia punible, much of confusion has arisen from the common use of such descriptive phrase as homicide through recklessness, imprudence, and the like, when the strict technical sense is more accurately reckless imprudence resulting in homicide or simple imprudence causing damages to property.